Caroline here, and today we are talking about episode 13, the season finale of Shadowhunters! I actually really liked this episode. I thought the episode was done so well, and the acting was fantastic, and the writing was so good, and it was just all so amazing, and I really liked it. I was shouting things at my screen, I was laughing, I was getting involved. Why is it the last episode? Why have I got to wait a year now to hope that season two is going to be as good as the finale? It was definitely one of my favourite episodes of the whole season, and I really hope that they take note of what people are saying about it and that they actually pay attention and that the writing and the story and all of it in season two is just as good as the final episode of season one, because I really enjoyed it. That's it for the non-spoilery section. I'm going to go in detail and discuss the episodes. If you haven't seen it yet, then don't carry on watching this video. But if you have, or you don't mind being spoiled, then stick around. Like, the acting was so good. Simon really felt like Simon, and he was saying things that really made me laugh when Clary told him that they had to find the book, and she showed him the bookmark, and he was like, what is it? The bookmark of the white? It felt like Simon. He had little sarcastic, snappy comments that just really felt so much like Simon, and I was so glad that that was there and that we got to see that. Again though, he was just walking around the Institute, like, how he shouldn't be in there, but we'll ignore that. Then we have this scene with Alec and his mum and dad. He confronts them after the whole wedding situation. Mary says, you embarrassed us all. If you just called off the wedding, that would have been bad, but it would have been better than what you did. Alec says, is it because Magnus is a guy? And Maris and Robert both say it's because he's Magnus and he's got a reputation and he's really not the best person to be getting involved with. You don't know him, he's really old, and you don't know what it's going to be like. And Alec says, I want to get to know him, and I'm glad that he stood up for them and that he decided that this is what he wants and he wants to go for it. And he says that Lydia saved his life because she stopped him from being stuck in a situation that he didn't want to be in. But they are bringing the issues that happened between Magnus and Alec into the series very, very soon. The whole thing with Camille as well, and they talk about Magnus being immortal, that's something that Alec doesn't even really look into and go into until at least book 4 or 5, so they're bringing that in quickly. However, if they do it right, it could work. Alec and Magnus's relationships gets better in the book once they actually talk about everything and once they open up about things and communicate. The main issue that caused page 511 in City of Lost Souls was that they didn't communicate. So if they actually do that and sort it out and they do it right in the show, it might actually work in their favour. But they brought those issues in very, very soon on, before they'd even gone on their first date. And I just don't want them to just have this whole kiss and be like, look, Malik! And then in the next episode be like, Alec's questioning everything and they're not actually gonna get together, because that would be really annoying. I love the handy CCTV footage in there as well, and they're able to just flip back and forth to see that it was Hodge. That was quite funny, that made me laugh. Also, another thing is, like, how does Valentine make circle runes? Like, I mean, unless you're Clary, you can't create runes, so is that something that he's learned to do, or is this something that he's gonna be? I don't understand how he's able to do that. Speaking of Valentine, Alan Van Sprang is absolutely 100% one of the strongest members of that cast. He is absolutely fantastic. He is scary and creepy. I wouldn't want to be near him. He's terrifying. He walks into the room and I just want to either run away or punch him in the face. He's so, so good. His acting is fantastic and he plays Valentine amazingly, and I really actually cannot wait to see more of him in season two, because I feel like he's such a strong member of the cast. And we saw Camille get let out, and every time Raphael would say something like, you need to listen to me, you can't let her out, she's too powerful, she's doing all these things, just watching, shouting at my screen, listen to him, listen to Raphael, she's told you where her apartment is, Magnus could find where her apartment was, they could find the book, they could find a way to get in, don't let her out. Camille ruins everything, and she came back out and she just causes all the problems. She's being horrible to Magnus because that's just what she's like. She knew Alec was coming, so she kissed Magnus so Alec would see, and she just ruins everyone's life all the time. And I just was just like, let's listen to Raphael. Why are we being mean to Raphael? He's helping Simon. Let's listen. listen to him. He's right. Keep Camille in this coffin and don't let her back out again because no one wants her around. But she plays that so well. Like, she has this aura of just, you want to hate her, she's just horrible, and that acting is fantastic. And I feel as though they did that whole thing so well, the whole thing between her and Magnus and Alex, that was just done perfectly, and the acting there was just so good, and I actually really enjoyed it, and I was getting so invested, and I just was shouting things at my screen. The thing that I liked was that they didn't really slow down the fight scenes as much. They looked like proper action fight scenes that were done well and choreographed well, and it just didn't feel as cheesy like they did in some of the earlier episodes, which was really enjoyable. And Jace in this episode was Jace. He felt like him. You could feel all the different emotions that he had, and that he knows that Valentine's his dad, and he doesn't want to really, he wants to be with him, but he also wants to kill him, and you can see those conflicting emotions, and you could just see that he genuinely believes that Valentine has done something to make Jace evil, to make him evil, and it was such fantastic acting from Dom, and I really, really, really felt for Jace, and also was mad at Jace for going with Valentine, which was the cliffhanger. And at the end, where he stood with him, and Valentine's about to start making more shadow hunters and start to create his army, and Jace is there, and I just think, what are they gonna do? Is Jace gonna actually, are they gonna change it so Jace becomes really evil and actually starts to help Valentine, or are they gonna be able to get through to him and talk to him and he's not? Because obviously, if they get renewed for season 3, by the sounds of things from interviews from the writers and stuff, if there's a season 3, we'll see Sebastian. It's like, we can't have Jace going all evil, because then that kind of Sebastian. I hope that they get to him pretty, you know, early on in the seasons, and they're able to help him and make him realise that he's not evil. Obviously, Jocelyn's awake now, and that's going to give us more perspective on the situation, and we'll find out more about Jace there. Acting for Hodge as well, that was really good, and those scenes were really good. Jace was absolutely losing it, and Alec being able to calm him down and talk more sense into him after that scene when he almost kills Hodge felt like the actual dynamic between Jace and Alec, and I really like that. And Jace cuts off Hodge's hand, and I know that it's like Family Channel or whatever, and not like a R-rated show, but there was just no blood. Like, it was it looked like one of those hands that you get in supermarkets at Halloween, in the like Halloween aisle, like the rubber hands. It was so funny because it just came straight off, and it sounded like a lightsaber noise, and then it was just this like rubber hand. Jace also got the ring, and Valentine knew he would, but he got the ring, so that's going to come into play somehow. One of you guys actually commented on my last video, because I didn't realise that he had the ring, and you guys said the rings that Clary and Simon used, and I was like, oh my god, yeah, and that's definitely what it is. Jace took the ring. I want to see if that actually comes into play, and the rest of them end up getting one, or they find one and they're able to communicate with him somehow. I don't know how that's going to work, but that's definitely a thing that's been introduced, and I want to see how they're going to play with that. This episode actually felt really consistent, and it flowed really well. The only issue is, again, the like downworlders in the Institute and the circle runes, and Clary goes to go through the portal, and Alex stops her and says, you can't go through a portal where you don't know where you're going, because you'll just end up in limbo. But in the first episode, Dot pushes her through the portal, and Clary doesn't know where she's going, she just ends up at the police station. So I don't know how that worked. Did she magic the portal so Clary would go where it was magic to go? I just didn't get it, but somehow that was a thing again where they forget what they've done, and it's like inconsistent to what they've already said, but it wasn't massive. I'm just being really nitpicky. I did like that episode, and I did feel like it was good. The characters felt like the characters, and it felt consistent, and it flowed nicely, and I feel as though it was done really well, and the writing was so much better, and I really hope that season 2 carries on like that. And this is sort of what's to come, and it's gonna get better, and it's gonna improve, and if it does, then hopefully they'll be renewed for more seasons, because the show isn't bad. Like, I've been making these reviews for all the episodes, and I feel like I just complain about it, and I know that it's different from the book. You know, they're gonna make changes, but they have made massive changes, and it has been a lot to try and get accustomed to. You have to sort of get used to the fact that it's different. Obviously, there will still be comparisons because it's an adaptation, and you can't expect someone to talk about a review of an adaptation without mentioning the original source and the original content that it came from, but I am gonna hopefully, like, season two, I'm gonna try and do it with more of a, less of a book mind. We'll see how that goes. I made a list of my favourite episodes from least favourite to favourite. That list is episode 2, then episode 1, then episode 3, then episode 4, then episode 5, then episode 10, then episode 11, episode 6, episode 12, episode 9, episode 8, then episode 13, and episode 7. We start filming season 2 very soon, so I am looking forward to the on-set pictures and promo and interviews, because I'm sure we'll be getting loads of them, and if you guys would like to have videos discussing them, let me know and I will make sure that we do get a chance to discuss them. What did you guys like about this episode? What didn't you like? Let me know and we'll have our final Shadowhunters chat, because I'm not going to be making the weekly videos anymore because the season's over and I can't believe that it's now April and that it's actually finished. As per usual, all of my links are in the description and we can hang out on other social media if you would like to do that. If you are new and you liked this video, I make bookish videos a couple of times a week discussing all things bookish, so if you want to stick around you can do that and we can all cry and fangirl over books together. Thank you guys for watching. I hope that you are all doing really, really well and I will see you next time. Goodbye!